This is a very important day. This is about starting a new story. Most of us appreciate a good story. It's a love story, adventure story. This is a story about autism. So I'm going to take a couple minutes to tell you my story. I had no idea what autism was, but I can tell you what it is now. It's a condition that's more common than diabetes, AIDS, and cancer in people under 20. As you've heard, it's 1 in 67 people get it. In Asia and the Middle East, it's 1 in 30. It's growing rapidly. It creates all kinds of suffering for the parents, for the families. It creates a condition of catharsis because you just don't know what to do. You just don't know what to do. So that's what we're hoping this hub can do, is provide an answer to people, provide a hope line to help with that story. Is autism environmental? Is it genetic? We don't know. That's why we just don't know what to do. But what we do know is if you have autism, I'd like you just for a second to think what it's like to be autistic. Close your eyes. Just close your eyes. Imagine you're in a rock concert. And the lights are so powerful, they're going through your eyelids. And the sounds are so overwhelming. And you're totally anxious. And you don't know what to do. You're autistic. And then noise and the sounds overwhelm you. And you retreat into your head. And you try not to look at someone because the eyes are the window of the soul. And that overcomes you. That's what it's like to be autistic. And what happens with autistic people is they have a lot of stomach ailments. And they have a higher rate of schizophrenia, bipolar, epilepsy. They get the wrong deck of cards, and we want to help them. As you can tell, autism really tortures me because I can't understand it, I can't control it, I can't affect it. It's tragic for parents. One day you're the blissful, proud parent of, let's say, a two-year-old child. You wake up thinking today's going to be like any other day. My kid's going to run up to me and say, "I love you, Daddy." Except that doesn't happen. Your kid might bite you. If you can get him to eat, or her to eat. The kiss that you're hoping for, the hug that you're hoping for, it just didn't happen. Something's changed. And you find out, over a period of time, that your life has changed. Everything you thought was familiar is gone. And then your friends wonder, what happened? What happened to your kid? What did you do wrong? What did you do right? You can't understand what's happening. And over a period of time, you find out that you're going to get a diagnosis of your child, and it might take 2 to 5 years. If you can get in, the hub is going to help change that. In British Columbia, that's going to change. About 5 to 10% of children who have autism will figure their way out of it. The other 90% will grow into adults. And 4/5 of the population of British Columbia are adults who will have challenges for the rest of their life.